That's easier. So that one goes on, that one still is off, and you do that and it's going on. So when you have pressed number 3 and number 6, for example, the code will say, this will say they are both pressed and the door will open. But if you want 4, you do it like this. Then you have to make this 3 times. You go first this way and like this. You do this the same, and then you, oh sorry, do this. It's exactly the same, but now you have to two of them. So when those are both on, this line will go on, and this line will, this one will go off. So this only goes on when you do this one on and this one on, and then this one will turn off. So now you have 4 when I made this one as well. What I'm gonna do now, now they are all on, but if I turn one off, this one will go off, this off, and this off, and then this one is off again. So they have all to be on for this one to be on. So that's this, and then we go to the numbers itself. The first thing you have to do is you have to think about a code. So, but I want 5, 5, 5, 5, 6, 9. Yes, that was it. So 2 times 5, I'm gonna start with 6 and 9. So you have to search which one is the right one. So 5, and this is 6. So the middle's right, this one. So I'm gonna make this like this, 6, and this is 9. So I know the ones that I'm gonna use. This is 5. Now I have to, this one and this one are easy. Those are one time. So I only thing that I have to do is to do this, this into that, and then it works. Only the thing is, they have to be turned on, and they have to stay on when you press it one time. So you have to make something special. You have to make something special with pistons, and for now I'm just gonna connect it with each other like this. Oh, I think I'm gonna skip parts of this because it's gonna take too long. It's a little bit complicated if you don't know it. You have to make this, and let's see, goes like this, and oh no, wait. It is possible with one. You need 2 repeaters and this. You have to make this. So when you press a button, it goes like this into there and back. So when I do this, you see it stays on. And then you're gonna need a piston to reset this. You have to make it like this. So when you press the reset, or when you press the right code or a wrong number, you have to reset all. So then this happens, it goes on and off. So you press the right button, it goes on, it stays like this, and you have one right. You have to turn this one as well, but when you press a wrong one and not one of the good ones, you want it to reset, because otherwise you can just press all the buttons and you get the right code. But so you want to reset it, and then this happens. It goes off again. So you have to, for every number you have to make this. And if you make a double number, just for two times, you want to use it two times, it's a little bit difficult, difficulter. And a tip, always make buttons for testing stuff and remove them at the end. But if you want to test something, it's handy to have a button. But now test it. So it's on, it stays on, you do this, it goes off. So that's the important thing. So when you should press 6 or 9, 6 is this one, it will go on, and if 9 this one, it will go on as well, as you see. So now I want to make it that you, if you press the wrong button or even the same button again for the second time, it would reset. So I have to first reset it, and I'm gonna turn the time today. But you have to make all the numbers that you're not gonna use, you have to connect those simply by doing this. And this, you have to make sure that they are all connected, and then you have to connect that with the reset. So let's see, I have this yes, I have all the numbers that I'm not gonna use for this here connected, and now I'm gonna connect that with the reset button. So now we have 5 there. We have to make the reset go this way, because you have to connect that with all the pistons. So you do this and this, or actually just this, and connect those all together and hang it. Like, do it like this, connect this and do this, 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 this. So, and then you probably gonna need some repeaters between the reset pistons. But when you press 6 now and 9, they will make go on. But when I press 4, it's a wrong button, it reset, as you can see. So when you press the wrong button, so you press 6 and then 4 instead of 9, so the wrong button, it reset. So you can't press all the buttons for getting the code. And now I want to make it so that when you press it and press it again, that it reset as well. And that's a little bit difficult because you have to make to do this. So you have to be able to close the way to this, and that goes on when this is on. So you have to do this, and you have to put lots of delay in it, or maybe no, 4 pixels is enough, I think. So when you press number 6 now, and this one won't fly. Or wait, that's one of the reasons why you want buttons over here, so you can see what happens. Oh yes. So when you press 6, this happens. It goes on, that goes on, and this one goes on. So when you press it again, nothing happens. It can't go in there. But what you want to happen, if you press it now, that you want it to go other way instead of this. So you want to do it wait, you have to make it it's so difficult this way. You want this to connect to the reset, so you go over here, I do it this way, and you do it this. So when you press it, it goes this way, but you only want it to go that way when this one is closed. So when this is on, you want to turn this one that normally is. You know what, I'm just gonna show you it. And it's like this. So it normally goes like this. This one is always closed, it has to be closed. So you have to do you have to do this. So it is closed. When you press it, it goes that way, and it closes this one. But when this one closes, you want that one to open. So when you press it again, it goes that way. So you have to do you have to connect this with this, like so. So when you have this on, I have to make this a little bit lower. As I said, you need lots of space for it. Because if you make an easy one, you don't need that. But so when this is turned on, it has to turn this one open. So when I reset it now, let's reset. So yes, don't know what happened. Let's see. Oh wait, when I pressed, and when I pressed here, oh I know, when I press it here, the neat one will go on as well. So when you press the reset, when you press it, the reset button, it will reset. But when you press 6 now, it will go on. And what happens is this closes and this one opens. So when you press it again, it will go the other way, and then you want it to reset. So when that happens, you want to do it this, and so now when you press it now again, it resets. So you can press 6 and it goes off.